Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren. And guess what, guys? I don't have a cast anymore. That's right. That means after like 2 months, my wrist is almost healed. Again, this is my semi-weekly reminder to Seattle drivers, watch out for pedestrians. All right, let's get into this week's dev news. First up, Build 2018 is coming soon. You can still register. It will be taking place May 7th through 9th, 2018 in Seattle, Washington. I'm going to be there. All your Channel 9 favorites are going to be there, and we want you there. And if you are there and you see me, make sure you say hello, because we want to meet any Channel 9 viewers we can. Next up, this week is, today as I'm recording this, is International Women's Day, which frankly, I feel like it should be every day, but nevertheless, we've got two episodes of Gals this week, kind of in honor of that. And so the first episode, I interviewed Lauren Tran, who is a software engineer in CNE, and she focuses on AI and machine learning. And it's a great interview. And then Golnaz interviews Beth Massi, who is the product marketing manager for .NET. Both of these women are amazing. Both of these interviews are worth your time. So check out both of these episodes of Gals and get your International Women's Day on. Next up, this week at Microsoft in both Redmond and Bellevue was the big MVP Summit for 2018, and I got to meet so many of our amazing MVPs or most valuable professionals, and you guys are just awesome. Thank you for all the hard work you do. Thank you for supporting our products and going out there and evangelizing and talking to the community and helping us do things. We really couldn't do it without you, so thank you so much, and the summit was amazing. Also this week was Windows Developer Day with Kevin Gallo, and this was a great developer day. We've got a link to the full video kind of keynote if you missed it, going over all the new stuff coming to Windows developers, coming with the next versions of Windows. And one of those new things was the AI platform for Windows, and basically what this will let you do is build in AI models and learning into your Windows apps. And obviously a lot of the computing, the hard stuff will still take place in the cloud, but now this can be something that you can actually leverage in your desktop apps, which is fantastic. Also announced this week is that Azure Stack integration is coming for Azure for Government, and this will be coming soon. Now, Azure for Government is the Azure for people in the government who have like really secret stuff that you don't really necessarily need to be stored, necessarily can't be stored on like a public cloud, that they need to be kind of on-prem. What's great about this is that it means that when this integration will happen is that people who use Azure for Government for secure stuff can still access the regular Azure Stack stuff. So you can have all of your private secret CIA documents in one place, but still access the VMs and tools and other stuff in another. This is great news. Also this week, and this was actually first announced on Twitter, Joe Belfiore gave us a little sneak peek on Twitter and then wrote a blog post. Windows S mode is coming to all Windows 10 versions soon. So when the next version of Windows 10 ships later this year, when people buy computers, they'll be able to get Windows 10 Home or Pro with Windows S mode enabled. And basically Windows S mode, that debuted last year. The idea is that it's a more secure version of Windows, and there are some limitations. You can only install apps from the Microsoft Store. It's a really good solution for schools or for enterprises. But the really good news is that if you do get one of these devices with Windows S mode enabled, you'll now be able to disable that mode and go to regular, Windows Home or Windows Pro for free. So that's a change and a little bit of a repositioning. But this is really good news for Windows devs, because if you are creating software that is designed for Windows S mode, you can now rest assured that it's going to be available on even more devices. Also new this week, and this is one of my favorite things, the Windows Subsystem for Linux, or WSL, has been around for a while now, and we announced last year that we were going to have more versions of Linux, Linux distributions in the Microsoft Store, because originally there have been SUSE and Ubuntu and a couple of others, Fedora, and now Debian, Gnu Linux, and Kali Linux are available in the Microsoft Store for the Windows Subsystem for Linux. And so Debian, GNU Linux, I think most people are probably familiar with that. That's basically kind of the granddaddy, one of the older Linux distributions, very secure, updated a lot. It's basically, Ubuntu takes a lot of its code from that, and there are a lot of derivatives. And then Kali Linux is actually a version of Linux that's really kind of designed for security, for pen testing, for things like that. So both of these versions are now available in the Microsoft Store, and check them out, especially if you're a Linux fan. Now it's time for my pick of the week, and because it is International Women's Day, and because I'm like wearing this, leather jacket, I had to say that the second season of Jessica Jones on Netflix is available now. I'm super excited. I haven't had a chance to watch it yet, so don't spoil it for me in the comments. I'm kidding, you can spoil away, it's fine. If you haven't seen Jessica Jones, it's a great show. It is definitely a little bit more mature and adult, so don't watch it with the kids, but it's a fantastic show. She even uses Windows computers in it, so I mean, I guess that could be a developer connection. I don't even really care if there's a direct developer connection or not. I'm just excited about Jessica Jones season two on Netflix now. Oh, and honestly, there is the Netflix app for Windows, and you can watch it in 4K on the Windows app or in Microsoft Edge, so there's that. All right, well, that does it for me this week. Let me know what you think in the comments, and be sure to like and subscribe if you're watching on YouTube, and let us know what you think, and we will see you next time.